So welcome to lecture 37. Now we will go to next level of complication. We will now consider transient analysis. Now transient magnetic problems for again in 2D, the governing equation will be this. So del square 1 upon mu del square A is equal to minus J 0 plus sigma dA by dt. So we are taking into account the conductivity and the corresponding diffusion term. So the global system of equation will be C A as a function of time D capital D D dabba by dabba t of A t is equal to B t. So this is representing the diffusion term and this sigma is directly reflected into this capital D. This as usual Laplacian gets reflected into this C, capital C, global coefficient matrix, which is function of geometry and material properties, into column vector A, you know, vector of or matrix, column matrix of magnetic vector potentials, which are function of time t. Now, most popular time discretization technique is this. What you do is, you basically this A t plus delta t, that means magnetic vector potential at t plus delta t minus A of t divided by delta t, you express as beta times dabba A by dabba t at t plus delta t plus 1 minus beta dabba A by dabba t at time t. So this is the most popular discretization scheme. And what is beta? Beta is just you know, number between 0 and 1. So if beta is 0, then if you substitute it here, this will go to 0 and then this beta is 0. So this remains just dabba A by dabba t at time t is equal to A t plus delta t minus A t upon delta t. So what we have done is we have expressed different partial derivatives with respect to time as a function of forward difference, because we are taking derivative of A with respect to time at t as a function of difference of A t plus delta t minus A t. So this is a forward difference because this is a forward in time, right. So basically A at t plus delta t minus A at t is taken divided by delta t is taken as dabba A by dabba t at t. The backward difference will be d dabba A by dabba t at t plus delta t is equal to A t plus delta t minus A t upon delta t. So here this what we have done, this partial derivative at t plus delta t is a function of this backward difference, because now we are at t plus delta t, so minus A t, so this becomes backward difference. Here since we were at time instant t, this was forward difference, right. So this is backward difference, beta is equal to 1, and then third is Crank-Nicolson, in which we take sort of average of partial derivatives of A with respect to time at t plus delta t and t, and then average of this is this. So for Crank-Nicolson method, beta is 1 by 2, so if you substitute beta is equal to 1 by 2 here, you will get this expression. So again, starting with this equation which we have seen on the last slide, if we multiply both sides of this equation by beta at time instant t plus delta t, then we will get this expression. So beta times this, so this is this term, beta times this is equal to B beta times this term taken on the right hand side, that is why it becomes minus, plus beta times this at t plus delta t, because we are doing this at t plus delta t. And then multiplying the same equation on both sides by 1 minus beta at t, you will get this 1 minus beta times this is equal to minus of 1 minus beta into this term taken on the right hand side plus 1 minus beta into B of t, right. Now multiplying equation A by matrix D, so we multiply this A by matrix D, so So then we will get here D, here also we will get D matrix, here also we will get D matrix. Why we have to do that? Because in this two expressions now you have D here, D times this. So we are bringing it to that form. So we are multiplying both the sides by D, right? And then we substitute these two equations in that, then we will get this total expression where this D times this is coming here, and then this beta times this, and this is being replaced by, because here D times all three are multiplied by D, all these three terms by D, and D times this and D times this are replaced by these two expressions. Is it clear? See, here we multiplied it by D, all the terms, right? And now what we have already got, D times beta dab A by dab T this, and D times this, we already have these expressions now, right? So D times this will be equal to this plus this, right? So that is what we have got. Now these four terms are on this side, and D times this is on the right hand side, right? So we have just substituted this and this in place of these two here. Now what we will do is we will combine this term suitably in this whole equation. So terms marked in blue are combined, because this is in A T plus delta T. Then this is marked in green is B D plus delta T, and this is B T. So that we are combining together, because both are in terms of B. And then third is in black. So this is A times T, sorry, A of T, and this is also A of T, right. So these two terms we are combining together. Okay. And then we are also dividing by beta here, the whole equation we are dividing it by beta, and then we are combining this blue, green and black terms in this equation. So for example, this just remains C A T plus delta T, because this whole equation is divided by beta, right. So that then other terms also similarly are adjusted and arranged. Now we are actually starting with this. This equation is rewritten here, okay. And now you can see the three schemes that emerge are for beta equal to 0, beta equal to 1 and beta is equal to half. So if beta is equal to 0, then you have forward Euler's method. You substitute beta equal to 0 here, this term will go, this term also will go, and what will remain is only D times this is equal to this, beta is 0, so this plus 1 times B of T. If beta is equal to 1, then that will give backward Euler's method, and then these two terms 1 and minus beta, 1 minus beta, they will become 0, so these two terms will go. So D of D times this will become simply, this is beta is 1, so C into A of T plus A at T plus delta T plus beta is 1, so then it is just B at T plus delta T. And then if beta is equal to half, which leads to Crank-Nicolson method, so there is a, if beta is equal to half, then it leads to Crank-Nicolson method, so there is a typo here. If beta is equal to half, then you get this. So then you get the average of those two terms. None of these terms goes to 0, and then you get average of the corresponding terms. So now let us see how do we implement this, for example, in Poisson's equation and then coupled to circuit equation.
In time domain.
So now our Poisson's equation is this. Del square A is equal to minus mu times J naught. So J you replace by Ni by S as we had done earlier in previous lectures, right? And then this leads to matrix equation C times A minus B times I equal to 0, where B at the element level for the ith node is N by S delta by 3. So that you can see in the previous lectures on current driven systems, we had similar expression, and voltage driven. This is voltage driven because I is variable, so I is unknown. So this will be voltage driven case, right? So now the corresponding circuit equation is this. This also we had seen it earlier. Same circuit coupled with finite element model. This is the field region and this is the circuit region. So this is a voltage driven circuit coupled to field model. So now the circuit equation, this also we had seen, U is equal to N d psi by dt R into I plus L di by dt, and this N d psi by dt is the corresponding terminal voltage here at the device. Then if you actually
apply FE formulation,
then U becomes G dash dA by dt plus R external I plus L external di by dt. This we had seen earlier. So now the two equations become CA minus BI equal to 0 and U is equal to this. These two equations also were seen earlier. They are identical to what we had seen earlier for voltage fed circuit coupled to field model
in frequency domain.
So combining now these two equations, then you can get this matrix equation. So you have in the first equation there is no dabba A by dabba T and dabba I by dabba T, so that is why you have 0 0 here, right? And in the second equation you have G dash getting multiplied by dabba A by dabba T. This should be dabba A by dabba T, right? And similarly L external is getting multiplied to dabba I by dabba T, so this one. And then plus now the multiplicands to A and I, so they are C here minus B, and in this equation it is, second equation it is R external into I, right? And then on the right hand side you have U in the second equation, in the first equation it is 0, right? Now actually we had got the same equation earlier for time harmonic case, but it was in time harmonic. So this equation now is in time domain, but same equation if we convert it into time harmonic case, wherein we replace dabba by dabba T as j omega, then we get this, and this equation we had in fact seen earlier, right? So here what we have done, dabba by dabba T is replaced by j omega, so that is why j omega gets multiplied with g dash, right? And now this, since it is, there is no dabba by dabba T, so now A and I become common and dabba by dabba T terms get multiplied by j omega. So then we get a simpler equation which we had seen earlier. So since now we are dealing with time domain and transient simulation, we will be working with this equation. Now following the method of discretization, what we did, if you remember, we multiplied one equation what we had. So here also we multiplied, there were this equation we multiplied both sides by beta at t plus delta t, and then multiplied by 1 minus beta at time t. So same thing we are doing here. This equation we are going to multiply both sides by beta at t plus delta t, right? So you get this, and then multiply both sides by 1 minus beta at t. So you are then getting, so this, that is why here it is t plus delta t, so here it is t plus delta t, here it is t. So all these superscripts are at t plus delta t, here they are at t, right. So, both the equations are identical, only the variables are at t plus delta t here, they are at t here, and here it is beta, here it is 1 minus beta, right. So, now we add both these equations, this whole equation and this equation, we add together, then we get this. So, what we are doing, we just, can you just see here, these terms are common, is it not? These are common multiplicands. So, they are taken out, and what is common to them is in these brackets. Okay, so it is here beta times this, here it is 1 minus beta times this, and then you get this entire equation. Now, what we will do is, we will use that equation A, which was there on the first slide, and it was beta times dabba A by dabba T at T plus delta T plus 1 minus beta into dabba A by dabba T at T is equal to this difference divided by time delta T, right. So, this actually whatever we have it here in this equation, we replace it by this. So, you get this, right. So, now same equation is written here again. This is the same equation what we have got here is written here. And now, the final step, what we have to do is, because this is a transient simulation. So, we have to bring t plus delta t terms on one side and all t terms on the other side, because we are marching in time. So, we already have values at time t and we want to calculate values of variables at t plus delta t. So, we are just rearranging this equation by taking t plus delta t terms on the left hand side and all the variables and their multiplicands at t, time t, on the right hand side. So, this is our final equation for implementation in finite element method, right. So, what we are going to do is, when we discretize all these by using finite element procedure, all these terms by our usual procedure, they are known, C is known, is it not? This is a global coefficient matrix, B is also known, right, G is known, R external, L external are known, everything is known, and beta, depending upon what we select, which scheme we select, beta will either, it can be 0, it can be 1, or it can be half. So, depending upon that, beta value will be chosen, and accordingly it will become forward, backward, or Kranz-Nicholson scheme. So, with this we complete this theory of transient FE formulation. In the next lecture, we will go to nonlinear formulation. Thank you.